Hello, you're watching Proactive London. Joining me today is Adam Wilson. He's the Chief Executive of Ben's Creek Group. Adam, good to have you with us today.
Good morning, Stephen. How are you?
Good, thank you. Proactive last spoke to you in early December when you started to extract coal from your site in West Virginia. This week, you delivered the first income. That was after receiving part payment for the first delivery of metallurgical coal to Integrity Coal Sales in New York. So, Adam, everything going according to plan?
Going very well to plan. That wasn't a part payment. That was a full payment we got for that supply that we delivered to Integrity.
Integrity, of course, is one of your offtake partners. Are you delivering to others already?
Integrity would take more than we can mine. They are keen to take more than we can actually supply. There's a real shortage of met coal at the moment. We've been inundated with people asking for supply, and that is one of the reasons why we hired the second high wall miner. We bought the second high wall miner, first one that we purchased, to increase production, because we're seeing huge demand, and that's also reflected in all-time high prices for the product.
Tell us about the second high wall miner, what that's going to do to production, and also how it accelerates production.
Sure, that's a great question, Steve. Thank you very much. It's the kind of question I like to hear. When we came to IPO, we talked about a target of producing 40,000 tons a month. All these numbers I'm going to give you are in clean tons. Very simply, when we mine from the mine, when we take it out of the ground, it's called a run-of-mine ton. And when it goes through a wash plant, it loses 50% of the rock and impurity, and then you get a clean ton. So if you think I'm out of the wall, run a mine, divide by two to get a clean ton. So we plan to mine 40,000 tons of clean coal per month in the first, getting up to that in the first 12 months with one high wall miner. Because of the very high pricing and the speed in which we were able to get mine open, we've now bought a second high wall miner, and that will double the potential production. So I'm now looking to get much closer to the 70,000-80,000 clean tons a month within a 12-month period. The first target, the 40,000, was in 12 months. So my now, with the second high wall miner, my target is 70,000 in a month. Now that's going to take me a while to get there, but with the very strong margins that are available, and I don't want to give the exact margin, but $100 is an easy number. I'm not saying we're, at a $100 margin, but certainly with the prices now very achievable, you can just multiply 70,000 tons a month by 12 by $100, and it gives you some kind of idea of how profitable this is and why we're trying to get a second high wall miner working as soon as we can.
So as you increase production, will you be looking for other offtake partners?
We're inundated, Stephen, with people who are wanting to take offtake, but our current partner, Integrity, have been incredibly good to us. We've got two contracts with them now. We've got the current contract. We're delivering run-of-mine coal to them. They're washing it themselves. They're that desperate to get it. I've got a second contract with them to deliver 250,000 tons in a year, 12-month contract. And, they are telling me they would like to do more. And I've got other offtake partners we're talking to, at least three other offtake partners that are keen to take the product. So it reflected in its high price. High Vol A closed last night at $400 a ton. High Vol B at $345. Everything we produce could be sold at these prices, all day long. So there's a lot of demand, which is great.
A good position to be in. I mean, last time you spoke to Proactive, you also alluded to potential acquisitions as you try to meet that demand. So looking at some of the surrounding coal lands, have you made any progress on that front?
Since I last spoke to you, we've acquired one site, which we're not allowed to give the reserve study, even though we've got it from Marshall Miller, because it's slightly out of date. But if you look at the acreage we bought compared to what we've got, the 17 million we've got at Ben's Creek, it is better ratioed. So per acre, there's more reserves there. And yes, we are actively looking for an acquisition. Got to be careful what I say, but I hope it won't be too long before we're able to announce real progress on that front.
And is the focus specifically on metallurgical coal, or would you venture into non-metallurgical coal?
It is, the focus is purely metallurgical coal. Sometimes the chemistry of the coal is such that there are outlying thermal coal, you know, with the met coal. Now, we don't intend on putting it back in the ground once we've taken it out. But the absolute focus is on met coal. There might be a tiny amount of thermal coal that comes out with it, but we're not in that market. We're purely in the met coal market.
Mm. And of course, you do have the funds to proceed with these plans, don't you, Adam? Because you recently raised capital, so $6 million in convertible notes, and you're drawing down on that as you need it.
Correct. And the business, of course, is profitable, you know, from its first production thing, which was we announced next week. But that's every week. I mean, every single week we're shipping every single day now. You know, trucks of run-of-mine coal, which we're getting half the price of clean coal, but there's twice as much of it. So we're shipping that every single day. So we're making that every Friday we get paid. I'm not going to announce every single week. I just announced the first one. But every Friday we're getting paid for coal that's being delivered. So, you know, we're now a profitable organization and building up cash.
Mm. Adam, what sort of news flow should investors be watching out for from Ben's Creek?
Well, I think we're nearly finished with the wash plant. The ability to sell run-of-mine coal has meant we can test the wash plant to get it absolutely right. That's ostensibly finished now. I've just got to run the testing on that 2 weeks. So I think when that's fully commissioned and tested with the best gravities and magnetite levels, we'll announce that. The railway line is very nearly finished. We're going to announce that. Hopefully the acquisition, when I can say more, that would be announceable. And there's no guarantee, of course, but I'm very, very confident. And then what you're looking for is us to increase both reserves and infrastructure. So I want to add second wash plant, second railway line. And all of that is a driver behind production. And as a company, we are focused on looking after our original shareholders, and how we intend to do that is by a dividend stream. So we're really sort of modeled on companies like Thungera, which span out of Anglo, where they're making a lot of free cash. And they want to give it back to the original shareholders that stuck with the story. So that is my underlying motivation here, is to produce a lot of free cash and then send it back to the shareholders in the form of dividends.
So lots to look forward to. I hope you'll keep us updated on any progress.
Well, thank you, Stephen, for following the story. Nice to have Proactive on again. And yes, I look forward to updating you, you know, either on the acquisition or, you know, as we increase production.
Good speaking with you, Adam. And that's Adam Wilson. He's the chief executive of Ben's Creek Group.